Hallie Laura, you for watching Prince Charming. Harry praises parents who look after their seriously ill children at home and even makes them laugh after inviting them to Buckingham Palace party for his charity. Prince Harry tonight paid tribute to inspirational parents battling to give their poorly children ordinary lives, telling them you're professionals. The royal was meeting mothers and fathers who have given their lives to raising their children at home despite major health problems at Buckingham Palace. The group of devoted parents have started sharing their daily experiences online backed by charity Well Child, of which Harry is patron. The number note nurse underscore but campaign sees them describe the medical care they provide for their own children despite not being nurses. Harry, 32, told them, "You've been able to share your experiences. Now you're professionals at this. You've got to try to share these experiences and help other people. I'd imagine it's one hell of a decision to say I want my children at home." The prince was speaking at a reception to mark the charity's 40th anniversary. Well Child has spent the past 4 decades helping families kit out their homes and gardens to make it easier for the youngsters to live their daily lives. Every year the charity also holds an awards ceremony for the children it helps, along with their families, attended by Harry. Matt James, communications director for Well Child, said, "Harry has attended the Well Child Awards for the last 10 years and before the award ceremony he meets all of our award winners. A lot of them are dealing with exceptional health needs and going through really challenging circumstances. Meeting Harry really gives them a lift and he allows us to get our message out." Harry was looking dapper for the occasion in a dark suit and blue tie and was certainly looking on top form as he entertained his guests. Among the mums was Hayley Smallman, 40, from Liverpool, who faces the agonizing knowledge she will one day lose her daughter Holly, who has cerebral palsy, chronic lung disease and epilepsy, among other health problems. Hayley said after meeting the prince, "One of the best days of your life, isn't it, when you get to have a one-on-one with Prince Harry? Our normal routine is so far away from this world and to be invited to Buckingham Palace for the day, it's just elevated us completely. All week we have been giddy with excitement." Prince Harry met the pair before when visually impaired Holly's sister Ruby was given an award for looking after her by Well Child in 2015. Hayley said, "Before he actually spoke to Holly, he said to me, 'How am I best to communicate with her?' I said it would be best if you held her hand and talked to her so she could feel you, use her other senses. And he gets down on his knee, and he holds her hand." Hayley said of the number note nurse underscore but campaign, "We are doing it for all the other children who are subsequently going to be born after our children because ultimately, my daughter is life limited, and I know I won't have her for a very long time. So the time that I have for her, I know that we need to make that time count. And that's what we are doing every day with this campaign." Rhian Greenslade, 47, a Well Child nurse, said, "Prince Harry was very friendly. I've been a Well Child nurse for 8 years and he was just saying how beneficial the role is. We talk to parents about the emotional and financial difficulties they face and help prepare them for bringing their children home." Harry also spoke to Sarah Mina, 49, who faces the heartbreaking prospect of having to turn down around 80% of families due to lack of funding. She is a co-ordinator for the Helping Hands Project, which provides house and garden makeovers so children are able to enjoy living at home. When she revealed she also sometimes has to say no, Prince Harry told her, "It's a tough job but someone's got to do it." Sarah later said, "We have to say no to about 80% of families so we were just talking about how we could attract more companies to help out." The project relies on firms to provide volunteers to help with renovations and the cost of materials, which alone is £2,000 per home. Thank you for watching. Please share video and subscribe my channel for more video.